Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to discuss and start a new chapter, that is Plant Kingdom of Biology. First of all, in Plant Kingdom we will be discussing about the classification systems given by various historical scientists, in which first of all we will be dealing with the artificial classification system. Now this artificial classification system is mainly based upon the vegetative characters, but it was said by Carolus Linnaeus that it can also be based upon the androecium structure. Now this system gives an equal weightage to sexual as well as the asexual characters. But there was a problem that this system was not acceptable because it involves the vegetative characters, which easily gets influenced by the environment. Now we are going to see the another system, that is the second one, the natural system. This natural system is based upon the natural affinities, that means the natural common things or common features which are found among the organisms. Now this is not only based upon the morphological, that is external, but also it is based upon the anatomical, that is the internal features as well, such as the anatomy, the embryology, phytochemistry, etc. Now there were two scientists, George Bentham and Joseph Hooker, who discussed these properties based upon the flowering plants by taking flowering plants under consideration. Now we are going to talk about the third system, that is the phylogenetic system. Now this phylogenetic system is mainly based upon the evolutionary relationships, and this is the most acceptable system. Now we are going to talk about the numerical taxonomy. Now this numerical taxonomy is carried out on a computer. This is a digital method. It is carried out on a computer. Almost all the observable characters are taken into consideration. Equal weightage is given to all the characters, and also numbers and codes are provided to each and every character. Now hundreds of character, one amazing feature of numerical taxonomy is that hundreds of characters can be taken into consideration at a time. Now we are going to talk about the fourth classification system, that is the cytotaxonomy. Now this is based upon the cytological information such as the chromosome number, the structure and behavior of the chromosome. Now we are going to talk about the fifth classification system, that is our chemotaxonomy. Now this chemotaxonomy is mainly based upon or takes into consideration the chemical composition or the chemical constituents of plant to resolve certain confusions. This is also used by certain taxonomists these days. Now we are going to start with first of all algae. Now under algae, they are considered as the chlorophyll containing, simple and thalloid bearing. Now a lot variety, or I would say they occur in a variety of habitats. Now when they show a symbiotic association with fungi, then they are called as lichens, and when algae shows symbiotic association with the animals, then they are called as sloths. Now their forms and size is highly variable. The colonial form, their colonial form is Volvox. Their filamentous form examples can be Eulothrix and Spirogyra, while the massive forms can be kelps. Now reproduction in algae. All reproduction, that is vegetative, asexual as well as sexual reproduction, takes place in case of algae. First of all, taking into consideration vegetative reproduction, fragmentation takes place as a form of vegetative reproduction. Under asexual reproduction, it takes or it occurs by zoospores, that are the motile spores. Now under sexual reproduction, it occurs by formation or and fusion of gametes, of two gametes. Now the sexual reproduction is categorized further into three categories. Now these three categories are isogamous, anisogamous and oogamous. Isogamous means similar gametes. Similar gametes, they can be flagellated as well as unflagellated. Under flagellated and similar, The example is Eulothrix and under non-flagellated and similar, the example is Spirogyra. Under anisogamous, they are dissimilar, but the gametes are called as Eudorina. Now, oogamous, they are oogamous means one large non-motile female gamete will be present and a small motile male sperm, or female gamete will be present. And the example can be Fucus and Bulbos. Now, we are going to see the types of algae. Now, there are three types of algae, Chlorophyce, Phaeophyce and Rhodophyce. Chlorophyce is green algae, Phaeophyce is brown algae and Rhodophyce is the red algae. First of all, taking into consideration about Chlorophyce, first we will be discussing certain points about Chlorophyce. Now, it is green in color due to the presence of or due to dominance of chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Another thing, their body may be unicellular, filamentous and colonial. The pigments which are localized, the pigments are localized in definite chloroplasts. What are chloroplasts? Chloroplasts are discoid plate-like reticulate cup-shaped structures which are ribbon-like or they are spiral. Now, they have certain storage bodies as well. And these storage bodies are popularly called as the pyrenoids. That is, they often store the proteins and starch. Another feature that their cell wall is made up of inner cellulose and the outer pectose. The inner layer is cellulose and the outer one is basically pectose. Now, they may store certain food particles in form of oil droplets. Now, let us consider the reproduction in these. Under the reproduction, all three reproduction takes place in this. Under vegetative reproduction, by fragmentation as well as by formation of different spores. Under asexual reproduction, by flagellated zoospores. And sexual reproduction can be isogamous, anisogamous or oogamous in case of Chlorophyce. Now, talking about Phaeophyce, they are generally marine in habitat and they have the presence of chlorophyll A, C and certain pigments such as xanthophyll and carotenoids. Now, the different colors are depending upon the amount of the chlorophyll, or I would say the amount of xanthophyll pigment present. That is popularly called as fucoxanthin. Now, the vegetative cells have cellulosic wall which is covered by an algal or by a gelatinous layer which is called as the algae. Now, the brown algae, certain points about brown algae, that the plant body is connected to the substratum by the help of frond, which is considered as a photosensitive or photosynthetic organ, and hold fast stalk, that is a style. Now, under reproduction, vegetative reproduction is occurring by fragmentation, asexual reproduction by biflagellated zoospores with two unequal laterally attached flagella. And under sexual reproduction, all the three, that is isogamous, anisogamous and oogamous, can take place under these. Now, we are going to talk about the last category of algae, that is the Rhodophyce. Now, the Rhodophyce, they are red algae. Mainly, they are marine in form and found in warmer areas. They are found from the low-lighted region in the ocean to the highly lighted region. What does low light mean? It means to the depth of the ocean and till the surface of the ocean where the sunlight appears a lot. Now, the red algae has mainly red thalli, which is multicellular, and they are complex and their body organization is also complex. The pigments which are present in these is chlorophyll A, chlorophyll D, pectose. Their cell wall is composed of cellulose, pectin and polysulfate ester. Now, their food is stored in special structure, that is chloridian starch, which is similar to glycogen and amylopectin. This question was asked in NEET 2020, that the structure which is similar to chloridian starch, under that we have to write that the components glycogen and amylopectin. Now, the vegetative reproduction mainly occurs by fragmentation here, asexual reproduction by non-motile spores and sexual reproduction by mainly the non-motile gametes. And here the complex, here the post-fertilization events are a lot complex. Now, in the next series, we are going to continue with the uses of algae and their examples. And further, we'll be talking about bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms. And then we'll complete the chapter by the plant life cycle. Thank you.